it is that I'm going to be speaking about, talking about, fluttering about, babbling about. All I know is that whatever it is, I'm going to upload and send. So, you know, so many things go on in my head prior to even hitting that record button, like, about what could possibly be spoken about, what is it that I'm thinking about, what energies are floating about, you know, and it's always a trial run through, get through, soar through, drive through. Breaking through our own addictions that we find that sometimes be our contradictions that people like to point. But you too. You know, there are so many parts to even having addiction. You know, people only like to work on the superficial layers and then find themselves still drawn back to the same addiction that they believe they need to rid themselves of for whatever reasons they may be, whether it's smoking a cigarette, drugs, alcohol, fucking pills. This world is on some fucking pill-addicted craze. I do not want to be part of that wave. I'm sorry. That shit changes people's personalities for their days until they kick that habit too, and that strain of wanting to fucking feel some numb, dumb, fucking drunk, don't want to feel anything inside, wondering why these thoughts fucking pulverize, I used that word yesterday and I fucking kind of liked it, pulverize their minds. You know, there's a physical habit of something, there's the habitual habit of something, there's the psychological aspect of that addiction to something, there's the emotional attachment to the addiction of something, there's the physical root cause of that something, of that addiction to something. All these attachments, all these chains, all these things robbing us, making us feel all fucking insane. Addiction is our worldly stage on display in different forms. Fed. And people just open their mouths and eat. Some people can't even fucking sleep. They take something for that too. I remember when I was like in high school once. I just wanted to be able to sleep without any interruption from these dreams that were so vivid as I slept. Family member had suggested one night to take a sleeping pill that they had so that I could just sleep. Granted, you know, so I took it. And I found in my own personal individual study of understanding what happened to me that night that I slept. You can say nothing happened, that it was a success. I slept. But I didn't remember what I dreamt. It was like emptiness inside, something missing from within my hive. I slept. But I became nothing at all when I slept. I didn't like its effects. So I was like, nah, that's not for me. You see, this girl loves to dream. No sleeping pill is gonna rob me from my dream. No pill. I used to not understand how my family could only seek doctors when absolutely needed. You know, we didn't do those regular checkups like we should. Only just abiding by these laws and standards of immunizations and all these things that you have to get and do physicals for school and all this other shit, right? And, you know, habits are always passed down, right? From generation to generation, unless one fucking awakes to their own fucking sensations and decides that this is not for me. You see? Yeah. They stretch in love with me, expand with me, vibe with me. For we shall awaken more of these seeds that need to be. all need to be catered to. We all desire this effect too. To be worshipped, to be liked, to be loved. Woo! I just got splashed. I'm gonna close my window. Wake up. There are so many layers into our layers, into our layers. Alright, let's go a little bit more, because there are some more motherfucking layers. Many lives, many many lives, many masters. What do you think? Who's the master? Who is the slave? Don't we portray and display and resonate with both master and slave? Or are we not both sides of every single fucking coin? Think about it. How do you know what you want if you claim to never have had? Think about it. How many lives? How many masters? If in this lifetime you've never been wealthy, and that's all you know to be the salvation of all your life woes, that having more money would somehow make everything better for you and your world, as you know, would be better than ever. How do you know if you've never had? How do you know you don't have? And that is exactly what it is that you want. Doesn't make sense, does it? These questions that I may ask, they're all rhetorical. I don't need your answers to your questions. For I only need mine. That's where people need to motherfucking get in line. We always want to know why, but for someone else. Like, dude, how the fuck is that gonna help? I don't need to know. The why for someone else. How does that help me get past, get through the things that I need to see? My focus should only be always, eternally on me. Yes, for the greater good of every fucking whole. But still, the focus that should always be what I behold is my own. This cocksucker needs to stay in his lane. Go ahead, I'll be nice. Patient. I'm love's patient, people. I wrote that yesterday somewhere on my social medias. I am love's patient, and I'm fucking impatient. And love just continues to fill within me in ways that I still do not fully comprehend. But it feels good, man. Such a dreary day for what I would love to stay in bed and lay there and shavasana all day. How often do you lay still? Rhythm and your flow and your beats and your breath and your heartbeat. Just emptying the vessel, filling the vessel, emptying the vessel, filling the vessel. Humans, beings, blind. We don't have fucking have. I'm thankful every day. I don't need tomorrow's fucking Thanksgiving to fucking publicize and fucking overstroll. Sometimes my words just don't flow. About how grateful and thankful I am. That's every motherfucking day. Every motherfucking day I cry, I pray. I release. And gratitude. It's always in fucking gratitude. That is my fucking chosen motherfucking attitude that resonates so deep. Yo. That shit puts me to sleep. Perceptions fed to our silly minds that receives everything so openly and blind. Let your third eye shine. You know, people wanna, you know, judge the artistic expression that goes into trying to show something that maybe can't be seen with our physical eyes, but just let's use our imagination, folks. Like, there's more to life. The fact that you even have a fucking imagination, what's that? If everything's so bland, dry, and what you see, then what the fuck would be the point of having an imagination either? Like, there would be no purpose. It would serve no purpose, no function. Robots. Zombies. Everybody loves the show Walking Dead. You wanna get in your fucking head right now? I'm not knocking it. I used to have shows that I used to like to watch and get lost into and fucking numbify my life more. What a nice, great little exit imagination door to explore and fucking tap out. Escapism. Every fucking thing. Just because we can. Just because we can. Just like that. Seeds. You may not feel it yet. Ah, but you'll appreciate the seeds at best. When they out of the blue just manifest. See, they can take every superficial layer that they think they see, but the root that's deep is the shit that is always yours to keep. That's why we must get to that deep to figure out what's the root of these things that manifest into our lives. Healthy are many of the roots that have been placed that can be uprooted and replaced with the alignment of you, but you gotta get to that fucking root. You can cover it in every single which way you think externally is best, but if you don't get to that root, that cause, that belief, because your root is your belief, hidden, it's just like someone that displays a whole level of like confidence and you know, they carry themselves in that kind of way, but meanwhile their root is distorted in many ways. The external, the superficial layer that others get to see or just look to see, cradled somewhere deep in his root, that beast is someone